Hi, I'm Dr. Becky Coats. You probably are wondering what happens during your TMJ exam. What am I looking at? You already probably seen a video about how I'm looking at a cone beam CT, but this might be the missing link of information to help solve the why. Probably no one's been looking at this, but let me show you why I'm looking at what your muscles are doing and how your jaw is tracking. On this screen, for every person that comes in for a TMJ exam, I'm looking at how you open and close. I know that probably seems obvious and you can watch yourself in the mirror and see if it's straight. I probably can't make mine look crooked right now, but I can help illustrate what I mean. So when people come in and they say, my jaw feels stuck, or it's hard to chew, or I felt like I got locked, we can show you real time what you're looking at. Kind of like wheels on a car and they're balancing it, and you know if you're shifting to one side, your car's out of alignment. Same thing would be for your jaw. When you open and close, this is what it looks like if you have dysfunction. Obviously, it's not a smooth line. Remember old school Etch-a-Sketch? This is jaw tracking. This is someone that their jaw is veering over to the right, and then to close, they have to get over to the left, or it might be a. So I'll kind of illustrate it. Like if your jaw's opening straight, if it veers to the left or right, if you're looking in the mirror, that means you have a TMJ problem. The tissue is stuck. Or just in smoothness, when you're opening and closing, it shouldn't be. You shouldn't have like a, kind of like a car, a wheel that's not moving properly. Next thing that we look at with also jaw tracking, when you're opening and closing your jaw, it's how much you can open, how wide, measuring that for data, so there's metrics. Opening, closing, and moving right to left. Let me show you what I mean by that. When you open and close your mouth, when you slide, both sides, the computer's tracking where are you limited in function. How does that relate to your TMJ pain and symptoms? If on the x-ray, your jaw joint has less space, that means you get stuck. You can't really go to one direction. Most people say it's harder to move or chew on one side. This is how we show in the beginning for someone their limited range of motion. When you open and close, if you put your fingers right here in front of your ear, does it feel straight to you? Does it feel like one bone is sticking out from the other? Be kind of like this part, which you touch right here. Does it feel like if you're in a quiet space right now, a pop, kind of like Rice Krispies? Does it feel like a stuck or maybe like a cement grinder? Those are noises that are picked up by sonography. Whether you can hear them or not, it quantifies how loud the joint is. This is someone who has extensive temporomandibular disease called degenerative joint disease. When you open and close the speaker from sonography that's over your joint, it will measure the type of sound, whether it's low pitch, high pitch, or grating sounds, bone to bone. When you open, that's sort of the sound that we'll pick up. You might hear, but it's measured in sonography. That is where the temporomandibular joint, this bone right here, it's getting flattened, like someone's polishing it off and grating it. I'll have a different video about how we can help stop that and prevent you from being a surgery case. When I look at muscles, a lot of patients say, you know, I hurt here. They say they have a migraine, or I hurt all in my jaw, or even the back of the head. And so I'd like to tell you very briefly when I'm looking at muscles, how that relates to your symptoms, why it's important for TMJ, because muscles help control how the jaw is moving. On the side here, there's a muscle called masseter muscle, right through here. That is the muscle that helps close our jaw with chewing, with closing our jaw to rest to swallow. This muscle here is called the temporalis muscle. Most people say, that's my headache muscle. If you notice, it inserts right on this jawbone, the temporomandibular joint. It's one for bringing your jaw back, and it's also one for opening and closing. Muscle relationship to the temporomandibular joint is also a missing link that maybe your physician, ENT, or general dentist has not even spent time with you about, to show you the total body connection, how it's really joint, muscles, nerves, how they all come together as a triad. Whenever I do muscle scans on a person, I'm looking at, what are your muscles doing with your teeth at rest, not touching, and what happens when you place your teeth together, your bite. Muscle scans should show me if the temporalis muscle and the masseter muscle, just by simply resting, not clenching, causes a severe imbalance. This looks like an earthquake. If you didn't know anything, you'd say, this looks like low, calm, squiggly lines. Kind of like a cardiologist that does an EKG on your heart. They're reading, right? So in TMJ diagnosis, you have to have a reading of what's going on with the muscles. If you just simply rest your teeth together and your muscles are firing, by the way, less than 2 is ideal and normal. Every day I see people with high muscle activity, and that's another reason why they have pain, and they complain of headaches, jaw hurting, neck pain, behind the eye, behind the ear, and head. If you'd be interested in learning more about how this relates to your case, call and we'll schedule a time for your exam. I'm Dr. Becky Coats with TMJ Plus.